Okay, here's a function. I'm going to point out some things about this function that we might be interested in. If you are an ant walking along this function from left to right, and you're going uphill, we say that that part of the function is increasing. Then we get to about right here, and we start walking downhill, and we say that this function is decreasing. Then we continue walking along from left to right, and we start going uphill again. We're increasing here as well. We're decreasing here, and then finally we're increasing forever in that direction. Where this function changes from increasing to decreasing, right there, at that point right there, we get a local or relative maximum. Where a function changes from decreasing back to increasing, right there we get a local, or we say relative, minimum. Again, right here we have a local maximum, and right here we have a local minimum. Now the big question here is, how do we mathematically describe where a function is increasing and decreasing, and where these local minimum and maxima occur? Well, as far as increasing and decreasing goes, it's the x values that matter. So the simplest example here, you can see from the value of x equals 2, all the way up to the value of x equals 5, our function increases. Now I'm going to leave a little bit of space here, but we have an interval from x equals 2 to x equals 5 where our function is increasing. It also looks like our function is increasing for all x values that are less than, negative 3? So for all of these x values, our function is increasing. All of those x values go from negative infinity all the way up to negative 3. And we have one more interval over here where our function is increasing. It looks like from all of our x values from 7 all the way up to infinity, our function is increasing. So these are the three intervals on which our function is increasing. We want to combine them using unions. And that is how we describe where our function is increasing. Let's do the same thing with decreasing. It looks like our function is decreasing from x equals negative 3 all the way to x equals 2. And it also looks like our function is decreasing from x equals 5 to x equals 7. We can combine those two intervals using a union, and that's how you say where the function is decreasing. Now let's talk about the max and min values. Usually what we want to give is two pieces of information, basically the x value and the y value. For this first maximum here, we would say that the maximum value is 5, that's the y value, and that occurs at x equals negative 3. And this is exactly how we would say it. We have a local maximum of 5 at x equals negative 3. We have a local minimum of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, looks like negative 8, occurring at x equals 2. We then follow along this path and we get another local maximum of negative 1, 2, 3, occurring at x equals 5. And one more local minimum occurring right here. Its value appears to be negative 5 and it occurs at x equals 7. Okay, we call these local or relative maxima and minima, or local or relative extrema, not because they're the largest or smallest values on the function, that they're the largest and smallest values in this little region around that point. So while this certainly isn't the absolute maximum of a function, it is higher than all of the points right around it. So we call it a local maximum. Okay, I think that's all I have for you in this video. I hope that helps, and I'll see you next time.